I got tissues for you.
I got one too.
Okay.
Here she comes back.
She's coming down.
She doesn't want to know.
They've been strengthened by their love and have received many blessings through its beauty and tenderness. They've learned that they can depend on each other and on the power of their love, and that through each other, they are every day becoming better people. Today, they come before us to enter into the sacred covenant of marriage, vowing to be partners through the trials and triumphs of their shared life. Amy and Robert have asked that we take a moment to honor the memory of those loved ones who can only be here today in spirit. Amy and Robert, your marriage will no doubt be filled with surprises. Some you will welcome, while others will test the strength and flexibility of your bond. Your life together will present many opportunities to refine and deepen your love and to explore the profound depths of your being. May you be compassionate with each other and nurture yourselves, each other, and this marriage with tender love and care. Deeply listen to each other, to your dreams, to your frustrations. Be helpmates. Be playful in finding ways to give your love anew to each other every day. It is your love that has brought us together here today. May it grow deeper and sweeter with each passing year. Amy and Robert, today you join your lives together, promising to walk side by side, heading in the same direction into your future. You promise to carry each other's hearts in the palms of your hands with tender love and care as you journey through the trials and triumphs of life that lie ahead of you. Now, if you would, walk over to this table and take your individual vessels of sand representing your lives from birth until today. As you pour them into the central container representing your shared union, symbolically blending your individual lives into a marriage partnership, walking the road of life together from this day forward. Just as those grains of sand can never be separated, so too may you be united in love for the rest of your life. The time has come for Robert and Amy to exchange their vows.
Choose you to be my husband, to be by each other's side through our life's journey together. You are my best friend. You are my precious love. You are the one I choose to spend my life with. I promise to cherish you, honor you, and to love and respect you. I promise to comfort and encourage you when we are healthy and when we must endure sickness, when we are filled with the joys of success, when we are burdened with sorrow. Robert, I promise to love you without condition for all the years of our life.
I, Robert, choose you, Amy, in the presence of our friends and family to be my wife and partner from this time forward. To love you, to be a comfort and safe haven in your life, to hold you close, to listen deeply when you speak, to nourish you with my gentleness, to uphold you with my strength, to weigh the effects of the words I speak and the things I do, to never take you for granted, and to always give thanks for the presence in my life.
Wedding rings are symbolic reminders of the unbroken circle of a healthy and abiding love. Within the safety and comfort of a true marriage, love freely given has no beginning and no end. Love freely given has no separate giver or receiver. Each of you gives your love to the other, and each of you receives your love from the other. And the circle of love goes around and around. May these rings that you exchange today remind you of the freedom and power of your love. At this time, Mike, if you could, please pass over these rings. clarify. I'm sorry. All right, repeat after me. As a sign of my love,
as a sign of my love,
and my knowledge that in marrying you,
and in my knowledge that in marrying you,
I am becoming much more than I am.
I'm becoming much more than I am.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
With the promise that I will love you.
With the promise that I will love you.
And keep my heart open to you.
And keep my heart open to you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
As a sign of my love,
as a sign of my love,
and my knowledge that in marrying you,
and my knowledge in marrying you,
I am becoming much more than I am.
I'm becoming much more than I am.
I give you this ring. With the promise that I will love you.
With the promise that I will love you.
And keep my heart open to you.
Keep my heart open to you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
On behalf of your loved ones who are here with you today, I'd like to mention some things that we wish for you. First, we wish for you a love that is rich, deep, and powerful enough to inspire others. May you love one another and love being loved by one another, today, tomorrow, and always. Second, may you sustain a deep and abiding friendship in which you are considerate of each other, kind, and thoughtful. Third, we wish for you a home that is a sanctuary for you both, a place of peace, freedom, vitality, growth, and humor. And in this home, we hope that you are blessed with a happy family. Finally, we wish that at the end of your lives, you will be able to look back and smile upon the life that you have shared together. Pleased, satisfied, and fulfilled beyond your wildest dreams. This is everybody's favorite moment. By the power vested in me by the state of Michigan, it is with great pleasure that I get to pronounce you husband and wife. Mr. and Mrs. Robert York.
All right, so first I want to introduce the parents. which are Mike and Allison Reardon. Here. And then we've got Bob and Jan are...
That's Jan.
Alright.
Okay, we want to eat sandwiches.
Alright, so Amy and I have been best friends for 13 years now. I remember having sleepovers and just being young and talking about boys and what it would be like to have a boyfriend. Little did we know that 13 years later I would be standing here giving a speech on her wedding day. During those 13 years, we have shared quite the array of times together, from girly sleepovers to late night drunken excursions. I remember this one time we sat on the floor in some random person's kitchen getting hammered together and talking. And talking about how happy we are that we are friends and that we will be best friends forever. Amy has always been the responsible one in our friendship. And of course, her parents always love to say that I am the bad influence.
We love you.
I don't know why you say that.
Time will tell.
However, there were some nights out where that was reversed. And I'm sparing you right now. Because I'm not going to go into detail about it. But I like to think that we even each other out, and we were always there for each other. But when Amy decides to let loose and get crazy, it's a great time. The cleavage comes out, boo starts going down, and you better watch out because Amy's dancing. Everywhere. Amy has had a few boyfriends in her past, and a couple of flings, but nothing that was meant to last forever. And then she met Bob. I have since come to know Bob very well, and I can honestly say that I love you. I love you, Bob. Like, so much.
That's my line.
Sorry. Plagiarism. I could never have pictured a better man for Amy other than him. The way they are together, how happy and easy their relationship is, how he makes her smile and laugh and so obviously cares for her. They are perfect for each other. I hope the future brings both of you nothing but happiness and love. And with that, let's raise our glasses to the new Mr. and Mrs. York. And I guess I'm supposed to introduce the best man, Mike, at this point.
Can we give Sammy another round of applause for such a great show? We also give a round of applause to the entire Reardon family and York family for without their guidance, support, and love, this day would not be possible. So before I get started, we actually have a few signs for you guys. These signs kind of represent some feelings we have for each of you today based on your wedding day. This first one goes to Bob. If you just want to read it and maybe hold it up.
Congrats, you're not going to die alone.
Amy, here you go. You want to read this one?
Sure. We are sorry.
And yes, you guys can hang those above your beds. I've known Bob since we've been 18 years old. and we unfortunately did not grow up together, so we don't have many of those childhood awkward, weird moments to share. What we have in the 14 years of friendship that we've had, made many memories and have some very good stories, some of which are only funny to us, but nonetheless, they're funny. And I'm proud to see you here today and say that I'm very blessed and happy to say that I am. Bob is one of my very best friends. Bob and I have a lot in common. And we have many stories that we've shared. There's one story in particular that I look back on early in our friendship, and I can pinpoint this being the time where I knew that we would be best friends for a very long time. It was a beautiful summer night, and we were at a friend's bonfire. All right, we got there early at a friend's bonfire. Bonfire, yes. We got there early, we didn't eat, we hung out with friends, played games, chit-chatted, all that fun stuff. As the night grew long, we realized we were hungry. And we looked at each other, and we realized there was only one thing that could satisfy our craving.
White Castle.
And there was the one and only White Castle. So that night, Bob and I went to White Castle, and instead of getting a couple of hamburgers like normal people do, we got a Crave Case. For those of you who aren't familiar with a White Castle Crave Case, I feel sorry for you, but it's 30 hamburgers. Bob and I brought this Crave Case back to the party, and around the bonfire we sat, and we finished all 30 in well under 10 minutes. It's slightly disgusting for most, yes. I don't know if the act of eating 30 White Castles is the most disgusting part, or the fact that we took some sort of pride and accomplishment that we did. As minor as that story may sound, the funny thing about it is the fact that it's 14 years later, and even as recent as last week, we reference that story and just laugh about it.
What are you getting out of the way?
Bob has many great qualities. I'm sure all of us can relate to a time where Bob found himself to be very excitable over something small and minor, and got that lovely smile on his face and laughed, and it became so infectious that we all in turn laughed with it. The quality that I admire most about you is your passion. You're one of the most passionate people I've ever met, and I truly admire you for that. Whether it's something big like his education, his job, his relationship with Amy, or his home, or something as minor as softball, fantasy football, or his March Madness selections, once he commits to something, he gives it his all, and he follows it through, and it's very commendable. I remember the first time Bob told me he was going to marry Amy. We were at the batting cages before a softball game. In between hitting, he looked at me and said, "Mike, I'm going to marry Amy one day." I remember thinking that this was fantastic, but I wanted to know more. So I asked what I feel any reasonable person would ask next. I go, "Bob, that's great news. Why do you want to marry Amy?" Without hesitation, he looked me dead in the eye and said, "Because she's awesome." This is true, yes. Albeit this was not the detailed response I was looking for. What I did take away was the confident look that Bob had in his eyes and the passion in his voice when he said that. I knew that we all would be here one day, sitting here celebrating their wedding. I'll also never forget the time that my wife and I were sitting with Bob and Amy planning our first double date. We were out with friends. We were talking about when would be the best time to have our first double date. As we were going through different days, Amy reached into her purse and pulled out the biggest daily planner calendar thing I've ever seen in my life. I was shocked. This thing was tabbed, it was color coordinated, it was intense, all right? I remember as Amy was flipping through these massive amounts of pages, I remember thinking this is exactly what Bob needs in his life. What I took away from this is that Amy is a very detailed person. She knows what she wants in life, and she's not the type to settle for anything. Since then, I've also learned that Amy is very caring, giving, loving, and wears her heart on her sleeve. And I stand here today, and I know that she is truly the best woman for my friend Bob. You guys are great individuals, you're wonderful people, and you make a truly remarkable couple. The thing that I'm most proud about you guys as a couple is you're always there for people. Whether it be through your teaching jobs, your coaching, your babysitting, or opening your homes to family and friends, you continue to be there for people. Whether you realize it or not, you've dedicated your lives to making people better and being there for your friends and family. And it's truly one of the many, many things that make a remarkable couple. You guys have such a strong foundation. You guys are truly each other's best friends. And looking around the room, you have the true support of a lot of family and friends in this room that you can always look to for advice if you ever need it. So if we could all raise our glasses at this time. May God bless your marriage, and may you guys have a happy, joyous life together.
Friends and family that travel from both coasts. We have people here from Florida, from New Hampshire, from California. We appreciate you all being here today. Ever since Amy was a little girl, she always loved dressing up as a princess. She'd always run around and dream and plan every wedding day would look like. So today, you look like the most beautiful princess, and we hope that all your dreams come true, and should be yours come true. All we wanted you to do is to find someone that would make you happy. The fact that degree and a job. So Bob and Amy have what it takes to make the long haul. They share the same passions like teaching and some hobbies like the Tigers, playing games on their phones, watching The Bachelor. Same future goals, raising families together. And Bob is starting out right. He never goes to bed when Amy's mad at him, even though when she sounds crazy. So earlier this week, my wife had gone out to lunch, and her fortune said that, welcome a change coming soon into your life. So that's a perfect ending to my speech. Welcome to the family, Bob. Introduce my sister-in-law, Megan, who's going to give a blessing.
Bow your heads. Heavenly Father, we thank you for everyone gathered here today in celebration of this marriage and the love that you know with us. We thank you for the food we share tonight in celebration of Amy and Bob's marriage. Grant that this meal enriches with wisdom and laughter so the memory lasts us a lifetime. We ask that you take this couple into your hand and guide them as they become a family and change throughout the years. May they always be aware of your presence and rich in your blessings. Thank you for the love, guidance, and support of our parents, family, and friends, and for making this day so enjoyable. We pray this in your name. Amen.
Let's give her a big round of applause. Let's give all of our speeches a big round of applause. They did a good job. Before we start dinner, what I'd like to do is have Bob and Amy stand for just a second. Amy's looking at me like, you are so fired. This is not in the binder. I'm sorry. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to make a lot of noise while Bob embraces his beautiful wife in a passionate kiss. Let's make some noise. Take your seats. One last announcement. Upstairs is closed off. There is another party, so please refrain from going upstairs. Thank you.
some noise. Yeah! Bob, you lost your first fight. Get used to it. I'm kidding. One more time, ladies and gentlemen, give him a big round of applause. And at this time, what I have to do is invite everybody out on the dance floor and share a dance with your bride and groom. So grab that someone special.
Keep it going.
Sexy Pants, and he's gonna put on one last show for you guys. Get out your cameras. We're gonna get this interesting. Cover the young kids' eyes, because this might get a little R-rated. But I think I got a good song for you. Here we go. Come on, we play baseball together. I can do this. If you want him to pull it off with his teeth, make some noise.
I'm making it difficult for you, that's okay.
I'm fired, it's okay.
Whoa, that's a little high, dang. Save that for the honeymoon.
Oh, I'm gonna give him a big round of applause. Not bad, sir. Now we need all the single ladies. We need all the single ladies. We need all the single ladies.
So 1 second, you ready?
All right, cool. Here we go. 1, 2, 3.
Nice.
Young ladies, stay up by the head table for me. I need all the single guys.